So I don't know about you, but entrepreneur is one of those terms I hear get tossed around way too much. So in today's video, I'm going to talk about the differences between a business owner and an entrepreneur. Now, initially, I didn't think there was much of a difference at all, right? I thought that business owners, entrepreneurs, they were all the same thing, right? But as I've learned through, you know, my studies and talking to different people, actually, they're quite different. So let's jump into that. Now, like I said before, I didn't think there was much of a difference, right? And one time I remember I was talking to this guy and I asked him a question. I said, do you think there's a difference between business owners and entrepreneurs? He thought about it for a second and then he said, yeah. So as he explained to me, this is how he broke it down. Basically, let's start with entrepreneurs. Now he said, entrepreneurs are somebody who actually build a business, right? They build it up, they scale it up, and then they might even take that business and sell it. On the flip side, he labeled a business owner more so as an owner operator. So basically he said, if you think about the guy who owns the pizza shop, right? He's the owner of the pizza shop. You all know him, your local pizza shop. And you go there and you see him working every day at the pizza shop. Well, he said, that's the difference, right? That guy is an owner operator as opposed to an entrepreneur. And we all know people like this, right? So for example, you got somebody like Elon Musk, right? He has Tesla, he has SpaceX, he has whatever else going on, right? He's a huge famous entrepreneur, right? And then we all know the guy who works at the local pizza shop around the corner from us, right? You see him there every day. He's the owner operator. And I can see where that mix up would come into play because nowadays we live in the gig economy. So whether you're a freelancer, you drive Uber or Lyft, maybe you do DoorDash or something along those lines, you technically are a small business owner. And what qualifies you as a small business owner is that your income is 1099 instead of W-2. So I guess since technically you're a small business owner, most people might consider themselves an entrepreneur, but there are some differences, right? So let's think about it. An entrepreneur is somebody who builds up a business, right? So I said the Elon Musk example, right, with SpaceX or Tesla, which he's more, you know, well known for. But he's building that company up. Now, the difference is that Elon Musk is not building every single car, right? He's not doing all of the marketing and all of the promotion, right? Basically, he's overseeing this large operation. So when it comes to entrepreneurs, basically they build up a system, right? There's a system that goes into building the cars and shipping the cars and sourcing the products, right? He's not the one doing all of that. On the flip side, you have the owner operator, right? Who's actually making the product. He's the one baking the pizzas, right? It's a big difference, right? So he might have employees in place and people who help him and work that he, you know, has hired out. But at the same time, he's in the business. Whereas on the flip side, an entrepreneur has the system working for him or her, and basically they just oversee it. So now the big difference between the two of these, because there is overlap, you do have entrepreneurs who work in the business, right? But the main thing is that entrepreneurs are working to replace themselves. Essentially, they're gonna have this business flowing, this system running, and they're gonna be able to teach other people how to perform the task and operations to the point where they can step out of the business and just, you know, run the business, right? Instead of being in the business, now they just work on the business. So the flip side to that is being the owner operator. And sometimes that's good, but sometimes, a lot of times, it can be dangerous because you can't be replaced. Essentially, you are the business. You are the face of the business. So if you're a freelance photographer or a videographer, you drive DoorDash or Uber, whatever the case may be, a lot of times when you're done, so is the business as well. And that's one of the biggest differences between being an entrepreneur and a business owner or an owner operator. Now, a great book that talks about this subject is The E-Myth, right? And basically, he's basically saying there's this myth of you being an entrepreneur, right? Who wrote this book? Michael Gerber, okay, wrote this book. It's a great book. I recommend everybody read it. But essentially, what he says is that when you're building your business, when you're working on your business, you want to make your business like a McDonald's, right? You want it to be turnkey. You want it to have procedures. You want it to be, you want everything to be documented, right? So that there's different positions within the business and then you know how to fill those roles. And those roles have specific tasks and guidelines that help whoever is filling that role execute those duties. Whereas when you're a freelancer, and it's just you, you're doing all the roles, right? You're growing the business, you're marketing the business, you're doing everything from customer orders to customer fulfillment. And so what he stresses in this book is that you want to try to make your business essentially be able to work without you, because then at that point, you have a real business, right? Now you can take that business and you can duplicate it over and over and over and over again. On the flip side, if you're the owner operator, you can't do that, right? You're at one location. Now, maybe you can open up, you know, another location or another one here and there, but essentially it's harder to scale because it's more so dependent on the individual as opposed to dependent on the system, which can make things really tricky because if you are a freelancer, right, you're a solopreneur. I'm gonna put it that way. You're a solopreneur. We all want to be busy. We all want to be successful, right? But the problem is that you can become a prisoner of your own success, right? The more success that you get, the more, you know, you are needed to be there, the more time you have to put in. Whereas if you have a system, the more success you have, all you got to do is keep, you know, fine tuning and tweaking the system. You don't have to put in more hours per se or give more of yourself. You basically just have to beef up the system to be able to handle the amount of success or business that's coming in. So with that being said, the goal of your business should be to actually build a business with the intention that you could sell it, right? So in this book, once again, The E-Myth, I'm gonna recommend this. I think everybody should read it, especially if you're a freelancer or you're just starting a business. But essentially, the goal is you wanna build a business that one day you could possibly sell. And if you can sell a business, then that means that you don't have to be a part of it and the business can keep running independently. Now, I know that it takes time, especially for the people out there who are freelancers or are part of the gig economy who are technically considered a small business. But if you think about it and you keep working towards it, you can figure out different things that you can do or different types of ideas of businesses that you can build that can still play to your skill set. So if you're good at photography, you're good at video or graphic design or whatever the case may be, okay, you can still build up a business that's unique to your skill set but can run without you. That's the whole goal. And so you want to take time to identify, figure out your business, see how much you can actually scale it, because the more you can scale it, the better chance you have of selling it. And also the more you can scale it, that means the less that you have to be involved in the day-to-day operations, or more so the mundane tasks, right? You're not the one doing every single thing. It could be a tall order, but it can be done. You just have to give it some thought and take some time. So I'm going to leave a link in the description below for the book, The E-Myth by Michael Gerber. I suggest that everybody checks it out. It's really a good read. It's a real easy read. And it does make you sit back, look at your business, and think about how you're running your business, how you're building your business, and how you can build it going forward in the future. So this way you can reclaim some of your time and actually build a system that works for you, as opposed to you being the whole entire system. So hopefully you found that video useful and helpful. And if so, give me a like and drop me a comment. Let me know where you're at right now on your creative journey.